So it was 12th of May 2014 around 8 o'clock when I was packing my stuff because my summer vacation was starting from tomorrow and I am very excited to meet my parents. So I was excited and I was singing and dancing while packing my stuff because I was very excited to meet my parents after such a long time. And I got this phone call and it was from my grandmother. It was a fifth call in the day. Apparently when you start living away from your home, your grandparent misses you more than anything else in this world. So the first thing she asked me when I say hello is that when I am coming to meet her. So I am now very happy to tell her that I am coming tomorrow. Suddenly I had this idea of surprising her, of not telling her that I am coming tomorrow. So I tell her that I may not come at all this year. And I can feel the sadness in her voice and I could imagine her face being, you know, getting down and something. So she asked me, the next thing was that, sorry, I'm getting a little nervous, but she asked me that if she can come to meet me for a day or two. I smile at her innocence and I tell her good night, grandmom, and I cut the call and I went back to my packing. And so I finished up my packing and I made up this card with moons and stars and sun, and I wrote in very big bold letters surprise, and I kept it in a very safe pocket of my bag. Next day, 13th of May, I reached Delhi around 12 or 1 p.m. and I am settling down in this bus with my aunt beside me, and my mother calls me up and she says, she tells me in a very low husky voice that my grandmother died an hour ago, and I couldn't feel anything. I just went numb. I wanted to reach home as soon as I can, but I couldn't feel anything, and I did not even acknowledge what my mother had just told me. And I cut the call and I was sitting there looking outside of the windows, and those 3 hours felt like 3 years to me at that moment. So after 3 hours or something, I reached my home. I entered this room where her body was laying down, as you know, in Indian traditions, and so many people are there sitting beside her and crying their eyes out and heart out, and I still don't know what to feel, because I don't know, should I cry or should I, you know, what expression should I give to that moment. And I stood there because as a 14-year-old that time, that was my first experience with death, and it was the very first experience was with my grandmother, who I was very close to. So I'm still standing here staring at everything, and I went near to her body, near to her head, and I bent down and I whispered these words into her ears that, grandmom, you surprised me really, really very well. You know, your surprise was bigger than mine. And that was it. I stood up from there and I went outside of that room to never come back. I never came back to that room, to that area, or to that house. We shifted after that for a few times, and I never looked back. I never ever looked back. So that time, as a 14-year-old, if that day my grandmother could teach me anything, that was, which also Meredith Grey, a character from Grey's Anatomy, put into words, was, it's important to tell people how much you love them while they can still hear you. So it's my request to all of you that if there's somebody out there in your life who should know that you care about them or you miss them or you know anything, do it right now, because you don't know if today is the day or tomorrow is the day, or and we certainly don't know how long forever is. Thank you.